Hello, once again, welcome to Agiotech. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to protect cells or lock cells in Excel. Remember, you need to subscribe to this channel. Don't forget to turn on the notification bell in order to get updates anytime we upload a new content. So, assuming I want to protect my cells from being addicted, so whatever I have within my cell, I don't want anybody to do any change to it. How then do I go about it? So, we're going to lock our figures within ourselves so that nobody will be able to do some changes to it. Nobody will be able to even change the monthly sales as our title. Nobody will be able to do that. So in order to do this particular amazing technique using Excel, you can highlight a part of the source you want to lock. So when I highlight everything this way, I'll just right click, go to format cells, and then make sure I turn on protection, I turn on the lock. We are not done yet. After you turn that, go to review tab, and then go out, click on protect cells. Okay, you can easily set a password for this. So you can see password to unprotect cells. You can easily set a password for that, but for now I'm not going to set password. I just have to go ahead and confirm this. So select lock cells and then select unlock cells. So I just want to go with this, the default settings, and this cells has been locked. If I try to make any change, it's not going to work. So initially I have the privilege, or I have the opportunity, to be able to change those cells, change those figures within myself, but now I can't do any change because I've locked that cells. Okay, so right now if I want to unlock any of these cells, okay, if I want to lock, let's say I want people to be able to make changes to the name, I can just highlight that particular column. Okay, initially you notice I can't change the name as well. I've locked every particular cell. As if I want to give the option for people to be able to make changes to the name, I can highlight that and then go towards unprotect at the review, click on the ribbon, and we come to the changes group, and then we'll click on unprotect. So this time around I'll be able to make changes to the names that I have over here. Okay, I'll be able to make changes to that particular name. So basically this is just the basic way in which you can protect cells from being edited by others. I hope you enjoyed this short tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and share this video with friends. Bye bye.